It is past midnight, well past midnight, and Melissa's in bed, half asleep. She was awake enough that she could answer my question, am I allowed to practice guitar? And she gave a very firm yes, and she said it would be nice, I guess, to be asleep and hear me play guitar. Not making this up, man. That, of course, you could say she's not really awake, but you know, people talk sometimes during their sleep and they're not really awake, but yeah, whatever. And I posted a thread on, I'm gonna keep this quiet if I can. I posted a thread on Facebook showing how nobody's watching my videos, and people were upset with me. They were like, of course we're not watching your videos. Go back to comedy. And I just had to cope. And yeah, things are pretty okay. A lot of people are, the people who do watch my videos say I should shut up and just play. And I'm going to try to do that, but if you have seen a previous video of mine, Melissa, who's my girlfriend, who's very important to me, says I should not force myself to be quiet, especially since I'm so lonely and isolated. Anyways. I asked someone who knows a lot about the brain, like, obviously this first section that we're doing here, the original chart that I've been working on for 3 months, which show the fundamental chords at the top of the fretboard, the top of the neck, if, I don't know if that's the right way to say it. So these original chords I've been working on essentially. Like, I've added some here and there, but I've essentially been working on them for 3 months since I started playing guitar, since I first got my guitar in tune. And, just asking about, like, memory and if I stopped, would I remember, how long it would take to forget, stuff like that. Because that's something that kind of interests me. I don't plan to stop, but I know with so many different activities, so many different activities that I've attempted to get into, like I tried to do painting for a while, a lot shorter period of time than I'm doing this, I just give up, or like, you know, not give up. Give up implies like I lost, but I just stopped being interested. Anyways. is something I'm interested in, and say, like, I give up, or, you know, I'll just say stop if I just stop playing guitar. And then 5 years, 10 years later, someone says, I hear you play guitar, you posted like 300 videos of you playing guitar. And I just, like, if I had stopped, and then I was expected to play, like, could I do that? So basically the question is how long it would take to solidify into my memory this guitar stuff. I also have the B's and F's. So what caged is, you know, the notes A, B, C, D, E, F, G, those are all musical notes to denote, like the A sound, the B sound, etc. So like caged is like basically saying, forget B and F, let's just work on C, A, G, E, D. It's out of order, but it's a mnemonic. So this section is the only section where I'm actually working on B and F, and I have to refer to this. I don't know if you noticed. I think my head's a little bit cut off in the video, but I went through the caged without referring to the chart because I have it memorized. And actually, now that I'm looking at the chart, there are two more things that I can be doing. This is, anyways, the point is, after I do these two G's, I'm gonna do the B and F. What I just said could be abbreviated into something that is salacious. But anyways, so here's G major, lower down the neck. And here is G minor. And I think I said in another video that basically at one point, I didn't think I would be able to do that at all, and then time passed, I practiced, and I could do it. And B, okay, so this is B major. So that's B major, and I've been able, that was like the first time I was able to accomplish a chord that is like this. Like, you see my finger here, we've got fingers on the 2nd fret and fingers on the 4th fret. And for the most part, like E, that's just 1 fret. E minor, that's just 1 fret, but it's on the 2nd fret. It's very easy, very simple. And then E major, you have the 1st fret and the 2nd fret. And so a lot of the caged here just deals with, let's see, C minor is 3 frets, but most of them deal with 1 or 2 frets that I have to navigate my fingers around, and B major, which I just played and I'll play again. Six string. Anyways, it sounds good with the six string not muted. B major was my first step towards it being more of a stretched out chord. Yeah. And for some reason, C minor, I never had too much difficulty with. I remember placing my fingers in the position of C minor and saying to myself, this is not going to work. And then it played perfectly and I was like, whoa. And I can get it perfect almost every time. Not bragging, because this is really simple stuff. So that's B7. And then here we have B minor, which... B minor, when I looked at it, I thought, there's no way I can do this. I have no idea how you put your fingers in this position. And, excuse me, dry mouth. When I got to learn the more advanced, the official, or I'm not going to say official, but the cage that my friend specifically set up for me, which basically goes from the top of the neck all the way down to the bottom, whereas this cage is all at the top. Anyways, I couldn't even conceive where I would place my fingers, and then I learned this other cage, and it got time passed and I said, so what are these chords that I'm not able to do? And I looked at them and I'm like, oh, I could do this. So, like, that made me happy. I know this is kind of like vlogging and everyone hates vlogging. But I'm sorry, I'll shut up now. Stronger, because that's a pinky supporting four notes or whatever strings, and the pinky of course is your weakest finger. I think there's talk in some scientific papers about how the pinky will eventually evolve out of using the pinky finger. Sometimes it's hard to separate science from science fiction. Like, it's like scientific desire. Scientists are legitimate scientists who know the quote truth, because science of course is based on skepticism. But they believe they are closer to the truth than other people. But then they get these, like, they get into these wishful thinking because they're human. So you get into these, I don't know, maybe some scientist smoked a little weed and was like, I think maybe we won't use our pinkies in the future, I think we're going to evolve out of them. And that he had such like an awesome trip from like thinking that he started like doing legitimate research into that being a possibility. So that was a badly tonal I wasn't pressing down hard enough. My fingers are sore enough as they are. But that was F major. And here's F minor. Which really isn't that different from B major. Sometimes you have to press down really hard, and who knows, maybe my neck's even bent already, like 2 weeks after getting the setup. But I got the setup and I asked for medium everything, so like how far apart are the strings. I asked for medium, what kind, do you want the pickups to be sensitive or whatever, like medium. And when I first got the setup back, the guitar set, but just call it a repair. When I got the repair back, everything was super easy to play, and now it's becoming more difficult. And I actually like it a little bit more difficult. If I had told them to put the strings closer to the body of the fretboard, it would be a lot easier to attain the notes, but for whatever reason, some people like it different than that. Like maybe it makes it, it almost definitely makes a different sound. I can't imagine how it would not. So here's another of these weird chords. This one is F7. So another part of it is my fingers just have to, like, my fingers look like there's basically indentations all over my finger, like all up and down. The camera, I've tried to take a picture of it, but my camera can't pick it up. But like it's, my fingers, especially the index finger, is like a zebra. And this is good because when it toughens up, it'll be easier to borrow the chords. Okay. So yeah, I'm probably still anxious, honestly. Like, it's 2:20 a.m. and I've got one anxiety pill left before 8 a.m. Sorry for talking all over that. I'll move on to scales, just because that's the next thing in the Alt tab. Thank you. if you notice, that's two different scales, and I just play them at the same time because they're so similar. Basically, here and here, I always mix up from here and here, especially when I'm tired. It's kind of funny. It's kind of not funny. It's kind of boring. Kind of scolded me about A, using all of my fingers when doing the scale, and B, it was part of the scolding. I don't think he needed to scold me, he was just happy. When you're happy, you get aggressive sometimes if you're that type of person. Anyway, so his stern words, which broke through my heart and into my soul, helped me learn a new way of playing. The progress and how good I am at the scale, I feel I'm moving very slowly. I am making improvements, but I think I just don't devote enough time and energy into it because it's a little bit boring to me.